Hello Taurus, welcome back to my channel. I'm glad you all could join me for another week of your general reading. So I pray that you all are staying safe and taking care of yourselves and just staying blessed and very grounded. So as you know, this is the channel where I give it to you straight, no chaser, but with compassion. But if there are some things in this message that do not resonate with you, then leave those messages at the door, leave them on the floor for somebody else. They will come along and pick them up, I promise and guarantee you. So if you want to book a personal reading with me, my information is down below in the description box. And if you like this video, please hit that thumbs up button. I would greatly appreciate that as well. And like, share, and subscribe to my channel. I would greatly appreciate that. So my QCs, my quintessential crew of Tauruses, let's go ahead and get into your story. So I already pulled two cards. I don't know what they are, but I pulled those for the end to see how you can handle this situation or what is the better approach deal with the situation. These are the sacred geometry of relationships. So, whatever relationship is, it could be any relationship, romantic, lovers, family, friends, co-workers, anything. So, I already flipped out a few cards, and I have, I'm always changing up my arrangement. So, I'm just seeing what, I'm putting them in like pyramid shapes. I like this, but some cards that already came out in a little pre-shuffle before. The story that is giving me right now is somebody got into a fight. Now, this could have been a physical fight, or this could have been just a fight of words, or, just mental thought or process or something. But I just feel as if somebody got into a fight. But I say it's words because we have the Five of Swords, and the Swords talk about communication. And then we have the Eight of Wands. That also talks about communication, and it talks about quick communication. But the thing is, the Eight of Wands comes out in the reverse. So it still tells me that communication still happened, but it was... Okay. And it comes out with the Six of Cups. So what I'm feeling is someone... Okay. If this was a fight, whether it was just a verbal argument, a verbal fight, it was a slow buildup. That's what it was. It was a slow buildup. And I feel as if it was a slow buildup because it involved people who were closely related. So whether these people were related by blood or whether they were just related by their own cultural upbringing or just, growing up together, however it resonates. But it's almost as if, as I say, it was a slow buildup. It was something that kind of needed to happen in a way, because it may have been some kind of patterns or some kind of things, maybe a bit of manipulation, just a bit of lies and deceit going on. So, if this was a habit or a pattern or something, maybe this is something that came up. But whatever this was, somebody did not fight fairly. So if this was a verbal altercation, as I said, or if this was a physical altercation, it wasn't very fair, but they think they walked away with a victory, but it was an empty victory. That's the thing. And it was an empty victory because, again, this involved someone who is close to them, or at one point was very close to them. So next we have the Ace of Pentacles, and then we have the Star card, and they both come out in the reverse as well. So I just feel as if I'm getting the term, it wasn't worth it in a way. Okay, it was, as I said, it was worth it because this needed to happen. Yeah, here we go. Six of Wands coming out in the reverse. This is a shallow victory. This was a shallow victory. What I mean by it wasn't worth it is this circumstance, whatever it was, it needed to go down. It needed to happen. However, the manner in which it happened, or some of the below the belt tactics, some of the things that were said, some of the things that were done, those things didn't have to happen. So for instance, if this was indeed a slow build up to something, it's almost as if someone was just unleashing every little thing that they could on this person, and they were taking out a bit of their aggression or their anger on them, instead of holding back a bit. So it was almost as if it was a no holds bar situation, no holds bar situation. Yeah, it was a bit of unleashing because here we go with the Seven of Pentacles. So they unleashed everything. You know, this energy talks about blocking out things or blocking out energy, but with this coming out in the reverse, you know, and being able to stand our ground, you know, pretty much. But this coming out in the reverse is just saying that everything just came out in the open. Everything came out in the surface. Next, we have the Queen of Pentacles in the reverse, and then the Temperance card in the reverse. So a very imbalanced situation. Very imbalanced situation, very unstable situation. So the situation could have already been imbalanced or unstable, but this, and this is what caused the argument, or this argument is what caused an even greater rift. Because here we go, let me see. We have this Two of Swords that comes out next, and then we have the Sun card. So, as I said, with this Sun card, going back to this whole scenario to the beginning, yeah, somebody was a bit more aggressive or more forceful than they probably should have been. But with this Sun card, some light has been shed on this situation. So, there's still some kind of silver lining that was still here. No, the tactics or the means by how things went down, they didn't necessarily have to happen. But, okay, we can't change anything. It's out there and it's over and done. Now what do we do about it? Do we grow from this? Do we remain stagnant in this energy? Do we remain bitter? Or what do we do? You know, do we establish our boundaries? Do we cut ourselves off from people if need be? Because if we got people in our toxic, in our energy who are toxic, or who are just, they don't really give any regard to our feelings, you know, and they hit below the belt, then sometimes we just have to kind of separate our energy, and that's okay. But it's all about setting your own boundaries, all right? So what else? You know, interesting, because now in another circumstance, and whoever this is resonating for, this victory, it wasn't victorious for the other party or the other person, but for one of these people, I feel as if they just been they've been blocking, you know, a lot of their words or a lot of their communication. They were holding a lot in, so they were keeping a lot to their chest, and it was taking a lot for them to keep that to themselves. You know, it was taking a lot for them to hold back. So as I said, this was a slow buildup. This was a slow buildup because we already started off out the gate with an argument. You know, if you look closely, you have this person right here who is dumbfounded and just bewildered and wondering what the fuck just happened. You know, and then just trying to gain his bearings. And then you look closely in the back, and then this person is in victory, looks like, but then there was blood right there. So both of these people have had some bloodshed, but you know, it's left one person, or however many people were involved, because this is just energy, so there could have been multiple people involved. It's left at least one person a bit disheveled or shattered because they weren't expecting this. So in some regards, and that's what I was going to say a few minutes ago, in some regards, this person was, as I said, this, whatever it was, it needed to go down, it needed to happen, but somebody was holding their strength back because they really didn't want to hurt someone's feelings. They didn't want to hurt someone's feelings. So that's why they were delaying this communication. They were delaying, you know, saying what they had to say. Maybe they just didn't know how to say it or how to deliver this news, whatever it was. But somebody figured something out because it's out there now. Or whatever happened. But it freed someone. That's what I'm saying. It frees someone. So they held back for as long as they could until they couldn't hold back anymore. So maybe it was almost as if somebody was poking the bear, and then they just had to unleash, and that's what happened. So I'm not condoning physical violence or anything of that nature. However, I am of the belief that if someone is antagonizing someone and in someone's physical space, then people have a right to defend themselves, for one, especially if they've let it go on and on and on for so long. So bullying, for some instance, children get bullied, but adults get bullied too, depending on where they are, what situation it is. So, and you know, if it's the same thing, if it's a verbal altercation, someone just taking so much mental abuse or so much mental anguish, then they're just gonna snap eventually. But you know, moving forward into this situation, here we go with the Nine of Cups and the Ten of Cups. So things are happening progressively as they should, and this is wish fulfillment and happy emotional fulfillment right there. So, and then Seven of Swords. I'll just show you all the cards and I'll just read. What is this? The Magician comes out in the reverse, King of Wands in the reverse, and then the Four of Pentacles. Oh, okay. All right. So it seems as if someone, whoever, you know, after this altercation, after this fight, after everything's come out into the open, now they're free to do what they want. They're free to go about, live their life the way they choose, go after who it is that they want, go after the job, whatever it is that they want. And, you know, they're just trying to find a way to strategically leave the situation. So, you know, they're trying to find a way to leave all of this behind, because all of this was a hot mess and it was just trash or whatever. I'm sorry to say it, but that's just what's coming to my head. And I'm just talking and just saying whatever comes out. So it's going to resonate for everybody. But obviously, as I said, there was some situation here where someone was just constantly antagonizing someone or constantly poking at the bear. So the dam broke, pretty much. The dam broke. So now that everything's out in the open, someone is now free to pursue or go after what it is that they truly want. And whatever that is, whoever that is. But whatever it is... pretty much the truest emotional fulfillment here that they could find. You know, with this Nine of Cups, it's everything that they've wished for. It's whatever they've hoped for. You know, it's the end all be all. So, yeah, very interesting, because this energy back here with this Six of Cups, it talks about past energy and it's here in the past. So whatever happened here in the past, now going towards in the future, now they're trying to go towards that. But however, it seems as if someone does not want to let go and they want to hold on tightly. This could be someone who's very materialistic. They could be wanting to hold on to the bag. They could be wanting to hold on to this person's money or whatever it is. And, you know, they're using dirty tactics to do this. And they're using dirty tactics to kind of undermine this person's confidence or undermine their self-esteem. So, one way to possibly undermine their confidence or their self-esteem is to go after their pockets. You know, so being selfish with them. So they're probably looking at it as, okay, you're being selfish with me, you're holding back, then I'm going to be selfish with you. So as I said, pretty much somebody's being petty here. So it's a tit for tat, get you back situation. But the thing is, this person who's being selfish and who is trying to maneuver this situation to their advantage and undermine this person's power, they are the original antagonists. They're the original ones who antagonize this. So if they should be mad at anyone of how shit went down, it should be themselves. But how should we handle this situation? Forgiveness. Forgiveness and abundance. I know it's hard as hell trying to forgive somebody who just keeps antagonizing you. And you know what? The thing is, it's not saying forgive now, because we can't put a time stamp on forgiveness. Whatever happened right here, if someone was hurt, if someone was disappointed, heartbroken, whatever it was, you know, you deal with forgiveness in your own time, and you do it when you are ready for it. But we never do forgiveness for the sake of the other person. We do it for our own sakes and for our own souls and for our, the peace of our own minds. So the more and more that we open up to forgiveness and love and healing, the more and more that we open up to receiving more. So keep that in mind for whoever needs this. So Taurus, I will talk to you all later. Hit that thumbs up button if you enjoyed this video. And if you need a personal reading, my information is down below. All right, my QCs, my quintessential crew of Tauruses, I will talk to you all later. God bless you. Stay safe and bye-bye.